Hi there, I'm going to show you how to move or migrate SQLite data to Postgres or MySQL database in Django. This is a time-saving tip that will help you to easily switch database or to prepare your Django project for deployment. For this demonstration, I'm going to be using this project, a Django React e-commerce website, which you can find in the link below, and you can go ahead and set it up as shown here. So after setting it up, I'm going to make sure my project is up and running. All right, my server is running and I'm going to check that out. I refresh this and everything seems to be working very well. So now imagine the scenario that I'm supposed to switch this content to another database, or I'm done with the website. Then now what I'm supposed to do is I'm supposed to take all of this content into my new database. It will be time consuming for me to input back all this data. So I'm going to show you for the easy way. So let me clear that up. So we're going to follow these few steps and do that in a couple of minutes. So I'm going to save all the data from my present database into a JSON file using this command. So check, well, here we have no JSON file, so I'm going to paste that in, press enter, and now you can see a JSON file. It has loaded all the information from our present database into a JSON file. For example, you can see the AirPods, wireless headphones here, and all the other data. So what we are going to do now is we are going to set up a new database, and for this I'm going to be using Postgres. If you don't know how to set up Postgres, I'm going to leave a link in the description. So my PG admin is up and running. I'm going to create a database for this demonstration. Let's call that demo, and my database has been created. So just to check that up, if you come here to schemas and you go to tables, you're going to see that my database has no tables, and that is true because I just created my database. So we are going to go now to Django and connect that. Remember, to connect that, you come to your settings.py and you mention that, or you put the settings here. So now I've set mine in such a way that if database is 1 and debug is 3, it's going to use my SQLite database. If debug is true and database is 2, is going to use my local Postgres database, and else is going to use my development database. So right now I'm going to use a local Postgres database, and which is a database we just created. The name is demo, the username is admin, the password is password. It's on my local host, and you can also use your online databases for this purpose. You can also copy the content from your local database to your online database. So now let's make sure this is up. Yeah, my database name is this, and I think that should be it. So now we're ready now to apply the migrations in our new database to create all the tables as defined in our manage.py file, which is here. So now I'm going to set that in and run it. All right, wait, there's something. Okay, I did not set this variable. Okay, for example, as you can see, if database is set to 1, it uses my SQLite database, and now once it's set to 2, it's going to use this Postgres database. So yeah, there were no migrations that were applied. So now I'm going to do that and press enter, and as you can see, there are migrations that have been applied. What this does is it creates all the tables as defined in our models.py files. Like for example, here we have a model called product. So it's going to create all the table called product in our database. So let's check that up. So let's go to this, and then let me refresh that. Okay, that is refreshed. Our database name is demo. And if I check now in tables, I should have all my tables. Okay, as you can see, I have all my tables here. And if you check very well here, this is my table called product. And that has been done. It means a database has been successfully connected and synced. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to exclude all content data from my present data, so I can easily load the new data in. So I'm going to enter the console, let me clear that up, paste that in and enter. Now I'm in the shell. I import content type data from Django, paste that in. Then I'm going to delete all the content type data using this command, and here we go. Then I'm ready to quit, and that's it. So the final step is to load this data from a JSON file in and into a new database. So let's just check, our database tables have been created, but now we should have no content in the database. Let's check that by running the server. So if I go ahead now and run the server, you are going to see that I should have no product loaded. All right, as you can see, we have no product. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to close my server, clear that up. So I'm going to load now this data from this JSON file into my new database using this command, python manage.py load data. So I'll paste that in, and that's it. Then press enter. Alright, all the data has been loaded from the JSON file into my new database. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to run server to check that in. And here we go, my data has been loaded successfully. That means I've copied the data from my SQLite database into this new database easily and without wasting time. All right, that's it. Thanks for watching and don't forget to subscribe for more.